Anne Shirley is one of my favorite characters from classic literature, so this video is dedicated to her unrestrained imagination and inspiring sense of wonder. Starting with the sculpted head, we will procedurally generate the hair and then animate them. All of this with a simple geometry node setup. First off, we need a sculpture of Anne and a separate object for her scalp. Select the scalp object, go to the Modifiers tab and add a geometry node modifier. Next, add a path curve and hit tab to enter edit mode. It's important to rotate this curve so it lies along the positive Z axis. In addition, it's also important to move the curve up so that the base is located at zero coordinates, as this will guarantee that Anne's hair grows outward from her head. Now select the scalp object and head over to the geometry nodes workspace, where Blender has already placed two nodes in our setup. To start generating individual strands of hair, use the add menu and the search field to bring in an object info node, a distribute points on faces node, and an instance on points node. On the object info node, select the curve we created earlier, and on the distribute node, set the distribution method to Poisson disk. The key point to note here is that by connecting the rotation output of the distribute points node to the rotation input of the instance on points node, we are making each strand of hair grow perpendicular to the surface of the head. Surely, if you want to increase or decrease the density of the hair, simply use the parameters on the distribute point node. Now to give each strand of hair some volume and the material, once again, bring up the add menu and use the search field to drop in a curve to mesh node, a set material node, and a curved circle node. The curved circle is used as the profile for the curve to mesh node and turns each individual curve into a cylinder that makes up each strand of hair. And to make each strand of hair thinner at the tip, select the curve path object and hit tab to enter edit mode, where you can select the top end of the curve and set its radius to 0 from the side panel. And while we are here, let's go ahead and select all the points on the curve, then subdivide them using the segments menu. This subdivision will give us better results in the next step, which is to add waves and curls to the hair. Just keep in mind that when it comes to the overall radius of the hair strands, you can adjust it using the curve circle node. Last, but definitely not least, use the set material node to further stylize the hair. Now, to generate the waves and curls on this beautiful carrot-colored head, take a deep breath and add a position node, a noise texture node, a map range node, a realize instances node, and finally, a set position node. Reduce the scale and detail on the noise texture node and switch the map range node from float to vector. Now glance upon the abomination that you have created. We've added waves and curls to the hair for sure, but why are they floating to the side of Anne's head? Before you dive into the deepest of despairs, let me tell you that the reason is that currently, random noise is being added to the entire length of each strand of hair, even at the base. So to fix this, we need to move the base point of each strand back onto the surface of the head, which fortunately is a cleverly simple task. Since all we need is a vector math node with its operation set to scale, a map range node, and a spline parameter node. The special node here is the spline parameter node, which has a factor output that starts from 0 at the base of each curve and increases to 1 towards the tip. Passing this factor over to the map range node and the subsequent scale node removes the unwanted offset at the base of each strand, meaning that Anne's hair is now securely attached to her head. Keep in mind that the scale value on the noise texture node allows us to adjust the frequency of the waves to make the hair more or less wavy. Finally, you can use the parameters on the map range node to control the overall shape of the volume of hair. This will come in handy in the next step, where we animate the hair and give the impression of a windy day. But before we do that, let me remind you that if you don't have time to read classic books like Anne of Green Gables, the next best thing is to listen to audiobooks. Check the description for an amazing deal on your next audiobook subscription. And finally, to animate the hair, let's add a scene time node, a normal math node with its operation set to multiply, and a vector math node. Now play the animation. Easy enough, we have animated Anne's hair, but freaking fiddlesticks, something feels a bit off about this animation, as it doesn't seem like the wind is moving through the hair. To see what I mean, just compare these two animations, where one clearly looks more natural than the other. The good thing is that we have a cleverly simple solution to imitate this natural motion, and all you need to do is to change the operation of the vector math node to multiply, add, and make use of the normal output of the distribution points node. Now if we adjust the animation speed with the multiply node, we have Anne standing in the wind, perhaps thinking. It has always seemed to me, ever since early childhood, amid all the commonplaces of life, I was very near to a kingdom of ideal beauty. Between it and me hung only a thin veil. I could never draw it quite aside, but sometimes a wind fluttered it, and I caught a glimpse of the enchanting realms beyond. Only a glimpse, but those glimpses have always made life worthwhile. If you've watched this video up to this point, you will probably also like this next one. And don't forget, you can get the project files for this tutorial using the link in the description. As for this one, thank you for watching, and until next time, take care.